And liftoff.
Astronauts in the International Space Station, they have a problem with their muscles, so muscles atrophy, they have a problem with their bones, so they lose the bone, they have a problem with articulation and also their immune system. So when we look at all this, we think they might have kind of accelerating aging. If the astronauts have this problem in a very short time, while we need 14 years in Earth, this will give us a huge opportunity to understand aging, and maybe we find actually a way to treat several age-related diseases.
They were enthusiastic about going to space, and they had the right ideas of what to do and what to test. What more perfect situation could you have?
To study the pathway of aging in this way, we were also the first to do this, from my knowledge.
So what we do, we take cells from patients, and we put them back together in a control environment.
So the idea is to mimic the organ, and where you could put all the cells present in the true tissue.
We want to kind of use our cellular-based system to model this and model the joint specifically in space using microgravity as an accelerant for the aging process.
And then we're going to send some of them to the International Space Station, and other will stay in Earth because we need to compare.
That's the plan, and we just put them in the smaller tubes, send it to the ISS. Very easy. This partner company called Ice Cube give us a box which is connected with computers, with cameras, with lights.
The students here at Botner can walk into the Space Innovation Lab, which is our connection to the International Space Station, and get data that's downloaded and look at it right away.
We would be able really to control all the sample every second, every minute.
This is the sunrise in orbit right now. It's very impressive. You've picked a very good time for this. On my day three of my PhD, I'm flying to the Kennedy Space Center to help on a rocket launch. It's very surreal.
It is very cool. We are all excited.
I watched science fiction. I watched Captain Kirk, and he would be on a planet and he would call Scotty. With this phone right now, I can do exactly that. I can call an astronaut on the International Space Station and talk to them and implement some really neat experiments and activities that will lead, I think, to enhancing our quality of life as we age. So in my lifetime, that was total science fiction. And it's now a reality.